Esther, Jaime, Tuttle. Come on, give them a great big Motown. God bless you. Hey!
Bless you, Pastor. Amen. Come on, everybody stand on your feet this morning. Everybody stand on your feet. Give God what he deserves. He deserves everything we have, everything that we can give him. Give him the greatest ovation of praise this morning. Praise God. Thank you, Pastor Rick. Pastor Renee, you can take your seats. What an honor it is to be in the second greatest church on the planet. I pastor the first one, Dwelling Place Church, Cleveland, Tennessee, and then Spirit of Truth. And I know you disagree with me on that, and that's fine. That's fine. But it is an honor for my family, minus my wife, to be with you today and dwell at Spirit of Truth. And I spoke early this morning to my wife. Always call her when we're separated in ministry and call her and declare a blessing over her. And she began to pray over me in the day today. And there's something about when my wife blesses my day, it gives me energy, it gives me strength, it gives me encouragement. But she said this, she said, Lord, I pray for my husband, my pastor, Jaime Tuttle, as he ministers today in Michigan. Lord, that the glory of your presence and your spirit would fall so powerful and so mightily in that house, that there would be a tangible and accessible glory. Lord, that the people, the body of that house could touch, reach up forward and grab hold of you today. Lord, I declare miracles and signs and wonders. And she began to pray and pray in the spirit. And I was just there receiving on your behalf. Amen. And in the next few moments, as we minister, as we sing, as we preach, as we prophesy, I'm asking you to do two things. First of all, is to open your heart, your mind, and your soul to receive everything that God has promised. We're not here to entertain you. I was not born to be an entertainer. We are not here to be a concert. We're not here to impress you. We're your brothers and sisters in Christ. And we're here to partner with you and to honor and to welcome the glory and the presence of God. So I want to introduce my daughters to you. This is Kaylee Tuttle. Amen. This is Erica Tuttle. And they're going to lead us in a little bit of more worship. Man, the worship this morning has already been octane. I mean, it's already been fuel on the fire. And I'm so proud of Kaylee and Erica. They actually are artists. They go by the name Kaylee and Erica. They're on their way to Europe. They're going over there to launch a youth ministry in Manchester, England in 2 weeks, 3 weeks actually. And the Lord is opening so many doors to these young ladies. I walk out every day. Actually, they walk out every day what God showed me the day that Kaylee was born. That they would rise, or they would raise up, they would become women of God and declare the mighty power of God to the nations of the earth. So I want you to welcome this morning my daughters, Kaylee and Erica Tuttle.
Can we just sing this out? You know what? Can we all just stand up to our feet? We were gonna go a different route, but I really just felt this before we came on stage, and I don't really want to move from this presence that I'm feeling right now. Can we all just lift our hands up to the heavens?
Oh, to worship you I live, to worship you I live, I live to worship. To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live. I live to worship you. Come on, sing it out. If if you know it. Oh yeah. To worship you I live. To worship you I live. I live to worship you. It's what we were created for. Yeah, to worship you I live. To worship you I live. I live to worship you. Oh,
come on, sing it out to him this morning. We love you, Jesus.
To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you. Everything we are, we pour it out to sing it out.
Come on, sing that. Sing that O.
You love to hear us, Jesus.
Sing it again. Some of you are breaking through something right now, just singing that. Come on.
We sing with heaven this morning. Come on, that's a victory cry this morning.
Just start putting a praise on your lips now. Come on.
Nobody like you, no, no. No one beside you, no, no.
Sing this out.
Sing, so there is none like you. And no one else can touch my heart like you do. And I can search for all eternity, Lord, and find that there is none like you.
Come on, sing it to Jesus this morning.
So there is none like you.
Come on, I know you know it.
Hey, no one else can touch my heart like you do. Oh, Jesus, I can search for all eternity, Lord, and find that there is none.
Sing it again.
Oh, there is none. There is none.
Lift your hands up to him, Jesus.
Every chain, his name is Jesus. Yeah, na, na, na. Oh, his name is Jesus. Hey, I'll pour out my love to the one I'm dreaming of. Oh, every idol crushed, 'cause he is the one, his name is Jesus.
He's never lost a battle this morning.
Sing his name, Jesus. Oh, yeah, 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 we love you. Oh, Jesus. Oh, come on, lift him up this morning. Nobody like him, no. Bright and morning star, and the keeper of my heart. He's the lover of my soul. Daddy, you haven't made me whole. You are Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
Yeah, you are Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
You're my comforter and friend. You're here until the end. Oh, the way, the truth, the life. Oh, you paid the highest price. You are Jesus. Oh, you are.
Yeah, you are
Jesus. You are Jesus. Oh,
Jesus.
Jesus.
There's something about your name. Come on, let's him Come on, somebody just start lifting up a shout of praise to Jesus. Hallelujah. There's breakthrough in this house this morning. Come on, he can't hear you. I wish somebody would lift up a shout of praise that lets heaven and hell know that you are here, you are free, you are victorious, you are no longer bound to the things of this world. Hallelujah. I was reading Job this morning. I was actually reading in Isaiah because I was trying to get my thoughts together. And I was like, Lord, what can I say? What do you want me to release? And I really felt, go to Job. And I was like, Job, oh my goodness. Because, you know, Job, you know, he was so faithful to the Lord. And I was just reading it the other day. And because I was like just needing some encouragement because it was just, I had a lot of stuff on my mind, and I was like, Lord, what can I just read to go to that, you know, somebody didn't give up. I need to hear somebody didn't give up. Somebody just kept going. He said, go to Job. So I said, okay. So I go to Job, and I start reading just a little bit of Job's journey, and I'm just like, wow, you know, he went through a lot. He had everything taken away from him. And at the very end of Job, God starts talking to Job. He says, were you there? And do you know who I am? Do you know what I've done? Were you there when I created you? Were you there when all this stuff happens? And Job says, oh, Lord, woe is me, you know, and just goes in and is just like, Lord, I'm not even worthy to even talk like that about you. And then he goes later, and I recognize something. And Job had to forgive other people to see a double portion in his life. All those people that were talking in his ear and were just like, okay, Job, you need to do this. And the Lord is not coming for you. And he has forsaken you. You know, and even his wife turned his back on him. I mean, bless his heart. So God says, if you will forgive them, pray for them, you will receive double portion everything that you have gotten. And he said, your latter will be greater than your former. So I believe this morning that there, and I really felt this morning, that there are some people in here, and this is a touchy subject, I understand that, but there are some things in your past you have got to forgive. Because God has something in his hands waiting on you. If you will just say, Lord, I let it all go. It's all yours now. He's going to give you a double portion of everything that was lost. And I can stand here as a testimony. I am in a season of restoration. And I can tell you everything that I once lost, God has returned to me double. And I am here at Spirit of Truth today to tell you God is about to pour out double on this house, on this community, in your houses. If you will just let go of everything somebody has done to you, somebody has said to you, I don't care if somebody has completely cursed your life, I'm telling you, God is about to give you double for your trouble. Can somebody shout hallelujah on that this morning? We're about to do this song, and it really just proclaims life to a generation, and that is what our cry is for ourselves, is we believe that identity is about to be released into this generation, that people that once thought that they were all in the world and they were drugs and alcoholics, they are coming back to life, to the real truth of Jesus. I believe that we will see in our churches more young people than we will old people. Hallelujah. Amen. So will you just lift your hands up to Jesus? Jesus, we praise you. We love you. Lord, you are so good. Come on, I want to hear you start praying. Come on. Jesus, you are so good. You are so mighty. I thank you, Lord, that this generation is coming back to you, that it is not in the hands of the enemy, Lord, but they are in your hands. I thank you, Lord, that you have a double portion for this family today in the name of Jesus, that everything that once was stolen is returning back to them double. Everything that the cankerworm and the locust have eaten, you are returning back to them sevenfold in the name of Jesus. We praise you, and we love you, Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. I can hear the rhythm. I can hear the rhythm.
We love you, Jesus, yeah.
That a generation is arising. Come on. We believe families are coming back into the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Somebody lift up a shout of praise for that. Come on. He is worthy of the praise, worthy of the glory, worthy of the honor. There is nobody like you, Jesus. We declare that families are coming back into the kingdom of God. We declare that nothing lacking, nothing is broken. We thank you, Lord, that you are sitting on the throne, that you are victorious. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Without any further ado, again, our man of God, Jaime Tuttle, he's a prophet. He's a pastor. He's a bishop. He actually functions almost in all five of the gifts, I believe so, and he's apostolic. So today, help me welcome Prophet Jaime Tuttle from Cleveland, Tennessee. Show him some love from Motown. Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Give your bishop a big God bless you. How about that? Give pastors Rick and Renee just an awesome, awesome God bless you. What a delight again. Thank you, Kaylee and Erica. Did you enjoy my daughters? Did you enjoy them? And just very quickly before I get to the word, and they have product out there. We have product out there. Here's their new CD. Their new CD. This This CD is already impacting the nations of the earth. I want to encourage you to go by and get it. Kayla and Erica write everything that they sing, with the exception of the familiar praise and worship songs that they did this morning. The CD is called Heart's Cry, and it's 12 songs that they wrote. They wrote the song Jesus you just heard, the song King's Drum. And Erica is actually one of our drummers at the church. She's probably should be number one, but I have to let those who are a little older have the priority, you know, until. But she played drums on the album. Kaylee played guitar on the album. And it's just an awesome, awesome project. I want you to go by and get it. And also, many of you know my wife, Judy Jacobs. Anybody in here know my wife, Judy Jacobs? You know, I was sitting at breakfast having oatmeal this morning at the Hampton, and these beautiful ladies sat down beside me, and they were actually there for a conference at the Hampton Inn. And you know, sometimes I have to drop my wife's name in order to create interest in me, you know. And so I recognized that these were women of God, and whenever they sat down, I just felt the glory of God on their life, and I just wanted to acknowledge that. I said, ladies, I just felt the anointing when you sat down, and we began to talk a little bit. Yeah, what do you do? Well, I'm a pastor. I'm in town preaching in a local church here, Spirit of Truth Church, and you may have heard of my wife. I'm just like, you know, listen. Because right at that point, they weren't even looking at me. They was just eating their toast, you know. And I said, you might know my wife, Judy Jacobs. Judy Jacobs! That's your wife? And they just quit. I don't even think they ever ate another bite. It was like, I said, yeah, she's my claim to fame. And but anyway, today I brought, I miss her so bad. I miss her so bad. We're not away from each other very often. But we have two of her CDs on the table today. Know God Like Jehovah, These Are the Days of Elijah, and then also an album called I Feel a Change. It features a song called Rain Dance. I don't know if you've heard Judy do Rain Dance on TBN or whatever, but those CDs are in the back. And then I have a preaching album that I'm featuring today called Blood Talk. This is three CDs that I preached, three sermons I preached at Dwelling Place, living in the blood covenant, the power there is in the blood covenant. I want to make sure that you pick this up today. And I just want to bless somebody with some product. I just want to give some stuff away this morning. I'm going to give these CDs away. Let's see. Where's, I won't do that. Here, Erica, Kaylee and Erica, y'all find people to give this stuff to. Hold on just a minute. I'll give it all to you. Just find people to bless today. Let's bless the people of God. Amen. And then this one right here. Now listen, this title of this one is a little bit strange. I preached this at Pastor Judy's Women's Conference, and this message is entitled "Get Out of My Bed." All right, I preached it, and the first thing that happened was somebody posted the name of my message on Facebook. It was a lady. She posted it on Facebook. She said, "Pastor Jaime preached this morning. Get out of my bed." And she says, "I'm declaring, get out of my bed, Jaime Tuttle." Well, that came back to haunt me. My wife said, "What in the world did you preach this morning?" I said, "Well, you know, they're talking about this message, but this is a powerful revelation of the prophet Elisha telling death to get out of his prepared bed." And I want to encourage you, go by there and get that. Let me just give this to this dear lady right here on the front row. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Go by and pick that up. Now today, Kaylee and Erica also have these bracelets they've designed. These are hotcakes. I'm telling you, this is something. All these words that they have on these bracelets are inspirational words that they have themselves come up with and designed. Some of them are titles to their songs, but I want to encourage all of you who can and will. Obviously, I tried to wear one, but it wouldn't fit my wrist. And so you can pick this stuff up on the table today. And it will go to support our trip, their missions trip to Manchester, England. Thank you so much for supporting our vision, our ministry, the girls, and what we're doing in the earth. We are currently planting three churches. I've got three churches I'm planting in North India. And amen. And I was just there last November. I was able to go dedicate a brand new church that we're planted in North India in a village of 10,000 people. And this church is the only Christian church in the village. And I went to dedicate the church. And the day I was there, there was already 200 first-time, first-generation believers. They didn't have Uncle Joe who was a believer. They didn't have Aunt Betty who was a believer. These were first-generation Christians in North India, and we had the privilege to build that church in that village. And so your support today means a lot to us because we use it to obviously the girls' trip to England as well as building churches in North India. So I just appreciate it so much. God's doing some amazing things. Amen? Amen. The Spirit of the Lord is in Michigan. The Spirit of the Lord is in this community. And the Spirit of the Lord is in this church. I'm not going to stand before you long. I'm going to birth this word. And then I'm going to pray. And people's lives are going to be changed. People's bodies are going to be healed. I woke up this morning and I had a vision. I got a confirmation on it a while ago whenever I was standing here in worship. And I saw two things. I saw two fields almost like a tractor road between the fields. And on one field was a spinning tornado just stirring up dust, just all kinds of debris and things just twisting and twisting and twisting and twisting and twisting. And then in the other field was this blazing fire. And I'm telling you, I just saw this today, and this morning it was confirmed when I walked in the room. And I began to ask the Lord, and I'm asking the Lord, Lord, tell me the meaning of the tornado and the fire. And I believe I know what it is. Anybody interested in what the Lord is saying and showing? The tornado is cleaning up the trash. The tornado is stirring up things that have been laying down, stuck and dormant, and almost immovable. But the tornado is coming through in the supernatural region of this area and creating a chaotic stirring in the supernatural. It's creating a chaotic debris clean in the supernatural. The fire is the following up of the move of God that I said of last night. And the tornado represents this cleaning, and the fire burning represents this burning of revival that's coming to the state of Michigan, to the region of Detroit, to Spirit of Truth Church. If you believe that prophetic, give God a praise in this house. And I humbly speak that. Is there an Annabelle in the room? Anybody named Anna, Annie, Annabelle? You have a grandmother, a parent, somebody? Anybody here, Anna? Anybody? Annie? You? Is that her name? That's her middle name? Okay, the Father would say that Annie is a gift of Him. He came, or He sent her on purpose, and that her life shall be fulfilled. And the weapon that has been stirred up, even in this season of the life of this house and this family, God says, I am perfecting and moving mightily, prophetically upon the house, upon the home, upon the child. And the child is actually an announcement of God's blessings on your life. And I confirm it because that baby's looking at me right now as if she knows I'm talking to the prophetic destiny in Annie's life. In Jesus' name, I declare it, I decree it, it is done. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Turn to the book of Psalms. Book of Psalms. Man, the praise and worship in this place today. I want the, what do you call, I know this is a small cello, or what is this instrument that my friend plays? It is a cello. He's going on the road with us. I know you'll miss him. We'll send pictures. I love that instrument. There is a breaking, actually, that takes place when a cello is played. It plays a timbre. There's a tonality that comes out of the cello that actually brings forth a soothing anointing that paves the way for the presence of God. Don't ever underestimate the stringed instrument. I used to pay thousands of dollars for Judy's orchestra, for cellos and violins, because I knew you can go listen to some of her music and you'll hear where we put orchestra on there in specific places in order for the anointing to flow in that point of the song. It's that important. It's that important. And I think he ought to play more often than he is. He ought to be allowed to, well, I'm not going to say that, but just there's a flow gift in that, Pastor Rick. And let me just say this, over the praise and worship, as I just continued from last night, songs and spiritual songs to be written and to be declared in this house. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm feeling some fire burning in this house. You got to learn to be prophetically releasing people. You can't be knots on a log. It's your word. It's your declarative ability that creates the ability of breakthrough in the house. So whenever I say, turn to your neighbor and say, I'm on fire, you're actually saying something. I feel fire. Anybody feel fire in this house? Anybody feel fire in your soul? Anybody feel fire? You feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost? You feel the glory of God resting upon the building? Boy, I do. Okay, Psalm 34, and it's already 10 minutes to 12. He told me we didn't get out here till 3. They booked my flight at 7. So I hope you brought a snack lunch. Psalm 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Verse 3. Oh! Somebody say, oh. That's two of you. Somebody say, oh. Oh is a word of interception. It's a word of interruption. It's a word that says, hold up, I'm about to say something. Oh. Everybody say, oh. One, two, three. One, two, three. No, don't play with me. Oh is a word in Scripture that says, I'm about to say something. Everybody come into agreement with me. One, two, three. One, two, three. Magnify the Lord with me and let us bless his name together. Let us exalt his name together. The word magnify. There's a lot to the word magnify. Anybody got a magnifying glass in here? Anybody just happen to be carrying a magnifying glass? Yes? You really do? I know I'm in the Lord's will this morning. Can I borrow it? Okay. I got one here and one here. Well, I'm going to take both of them. God bless you. You can find you another one at Walmart, I'm sure. These belong to me now. Don't let me forget to give these back to you. Did you need it? Okay. Were you using it right now? Okay. Oh, now this one's a cute one. All right. Now this is going to make me preach better. I can see this right now. There's something about the word magnify. Magnify is a word that says something can be made bigger than it actually is. Something can be increased, if you will. We wear these things. We use these. And, of course, I got mine. I got some bling up here, my bling glasses, you know. I can't see y'all right now. I just look good. I can't see you. You're blurred. You look like men look like trees, you know. But y'all just bear with me. If I take them off, I can see you. But whenever I'm looking at the scripture, bam, it magnifies. If I take a magnifying glass and I put it on this bottle right here, if I take it, man, that thing right there looks like 16 ounces. 1 liter. Oh, there it is. There's a gallon. We magnify, we make things bigger than they really are. David in the scripture is saying, 1, 2, 3. Come on now, listen. You're going to have to wake up. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. David is saying, let's make God bigger than our situation. Let's make him bigger than our problem. Let's make him bigger than our circumstances. Don't worry about the stuff. Don't worry about the trash. Don't worry about the garbage. It's just coming to remind us that we have an ability to make God bigger than our situation. Here's our problem. Somebody say, I got a problem. We lean toward the reality of making situations and circumstances the big thing. Oh, my goodness. You hear what the doctor has said? I don't feel good today. Oh, I feel horrible. Oh. I brought him with me. Sometimes we put our glasses on and our magnifying glass, and we make problems bigger than the God who can fix the problem. We look at things in a natural view of things, and we say, God could never fix that. God could never make that better than it is. God could never fulfill my dream. God could never heal my body. God can never deliver my children. God could never open up a door for me. God could never, and we use maybe labels or things and diagnoses and subject matters, and we'll go, God could never make it any better than it is. And yet David in a situation, we have to understand, when David wrote this, he was on the run. When David wrote this, he was in a situation where he was on the run from Saul, and he escaped to one location and went to another location, and he ends up in the king's palace. And here's David, to the point that he's so caught, he has to have a fit. You can read this in Samuel. He has this fit where actually translators and scholars believe he actually acted like he was having a psychotic outbreak. He started foaming at the mouth, his eyes rolled up in his head, started kind of acting foolish and silly, to the point that the king says, "Why? I've already got enough of these kinds of problems in my kingdom. Why is this cat in my palace? Get him out of here." Sometimes we have to act a fool in order to bring about our full deliverance. Now, some of you are struggling with that theology right there. Some of you, I ain't acting a fool, and he preaching like a fool. But stay with me now. The reality of this is sometimes you have to act out of your own character. You have to act out of your own normal. You have to be what everybody thinks you can't be. And they'll go, boy, she's acting awfully strange. She's acting like she is healed. He's acting like he did get a raise. He's acting like he did get increased. See, because sometimes the way you act will cause God to respond quicker than you thought he was going to. See, if you will act down and out, lost and undone, in a dying world, and you're defeated, and I'm magnifying my problem. I'm magnifying my pain. Watch this. What are y'all thinking about me right now? I'm in pain. Something's wrong with his foot. If I come in here and I, praise the Lord, ow!
Glory. Oh. And I'm not demanding anybody's pain. But let me just show you this. I can come in here and let's just say, if I talk from now to 3 o'clock, just like this. Hey, y'all know what? I'm gonna preach to y'all, but I'm in so much pain. I'm struggling so bad. You're not gonna believe how bad my toe is right now. My toe is so messed up. Brother, if you could see, hold on a second. I want you to look at my toe. You see that toe? If I talk so much about my toe, you could give me a nickname. That's Brother Toe. Some of you carry nicknames right now by the things and your personalities that you possess. You know? That's Brother Toe. You remember that guy that came up to our church? Pastor Rick brought him and his two boys, girls could sing, but all he talked about was his toe. He talked about his toe the whole time. Y'all ain't gonna believe how bad my toe is. Look at here. Let me show y'all my toe. And we walk out of here today, and all you got out of this message was how bad his toe was. We can take a problem, and we can magnify that situation to the point that all we have spoken is how bad it is. We decide that life is rough, life is hard, life is tough. But you know, life is hard and life is rough for everybody. Like, people go through stuff all the time. People face things all the time. But when David is saying, but in the middle of all that, oh, but wait a minute. Magnify the Lord with me. Let's come into unanimous agreement as a brother and sister in Christ. We know what we've been through. Look, but here's the other thing. I can tell you my history with God. I've got a history. I also remember when we healed me, I was on my deathbed in the Philippines, and they told me I wasn't going to make it through the night. And all of a sudden, I just thought, well, I can either lay here and I can die here, or I can lift my hands and I can say, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. It doesn't matter how bad things get. And understand this. There's a tornado cleaning and there's a fire burning. Let's keep going. Verse 4, I sought the Lord. Here's David. I sought the Lord and he heard me. Can I just say he's hearing you? He has heard you. Somebody in here, you got a prayer list as long, it could drive it, you take it out here to put it to the car. It's that long from here to the car. Can I tell you, like Daniel, he heard you the first time he prayed. And God commissioned the miracle and the move of God to go at that point the first time he prayed. Can I tell you that you are in the season of activation? You're in the season of demonstration. You're in the season of promise. Don't you give up in well-doing. Know this, my friend, that it doesn't matter how bad it gets. It doesn't matter how hard it is. There is a Lord, there is a God in Israel that has commissioned your ministering angels. And just when you thought it couldn't happen, just when you thought it was over, God shows up, busts up, breaks out, and does a great and mighty thing in your life. He heard me. He heard me. My mama used to say, James Eric, did you not hear me? We weren't praying at that time. James Eric, did you not hear me? And I go, no, mama, I didn't hear. Boy, you know you heard me. Just when you think God didn't hear you, he heard you the first time you prayed and delivered me from all my fears. They looked to me and were radiant, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried out, and the Lord heard him and saved him from all of his troubles. Here's one of my favorites right here. And I'm going to give you something here to put in your pocket. The angel, everybody got an angel, encamps, or the angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear and reverence the Lord. Let's talk about encamps. The word encamps here means this. Thank y'all for your magnifying glasses. The word encamps means this right here. Let's see. Let me find some volunteers. Come here, Scott. Come here. Come here, my good brother. I'm sorry I don't know your name. Will you take me for a ride after church? You're not on your bike?
I got a drop top.
A drop top? Okay. You help me out here for just a minute? Okay. And then let me see. Chrissy, you come and help me. You come and help me. Let me show you what happens here when we magnify. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. I'm about to say something, so I need your attention. The Bible says that the angel of the Lord encamps round about those who fear him. In other words, who reverence him, who make him bigger than my problem. And as I make God bigger in my worship and in my praise and in my commitment to him and in my prayer life and in my Bible reading and in my church attendance and in my sowing and in my tithing and in being faithful and reverence to the Lord, the more I magnify these angels, all of a sudden, just start hovering over me. Come on now. Come on. Come on. Press in, press in, press in. And then hold your wings out like this. I'm gonna get this. You've ever wanted wings? Right here's your wings. Okay. You got my back, okay. And the more I magnify, watch me now. Everybody, do I have everybody's attention? One, two, three. Oh. Magnify the Lord. And God, I just magnify your name. I lift you up. I don't matter the hell I'm going through. It don't matter the pain. And the more I worship, the closer they press into me and they keep me and they encamp round about me and they set up an abode and a place and a place of rest. And I say in Jesus' name, I thank you that I am protected. I am kept. There ain't nothing and nobody who can keep me from the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. Some of you, thank you guys, are wasting the angels' time. Angels sitting around picking their nose. Angels resting. Well, we're just waiting on somebody to magnify the Lord. We could just get people. We can't show up and protect and encamp around about them when all they magnify is the problem. Oh, my toe. Angels. Where are you, angels? My toe! Angels say, I ain't caring nothing about your toe, boy. You start magnifying my Lord, I'll show up. You start glorifying God, I'll move. You start exalting Jesus Christ in worship. You press in. You push forth. You put aside every weight that distracts you from the Lord. And then I'll move on your behalf, says the angel. Oh, magnify. Oh, and then David does this. Anybody getting anything out of this? He says this. He says, oh. There you are. Where's my glasses? Erica, you be my angel. I just thank the Lord for my glasses right now. Thank you for helping me there. David uses that same 1, 2, 3. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Taste and see that the Lord, he is good. You know what? I've tasted a lot of good food in my life. You can tell. I've tasted a lot of things. There was a commercial on television when I was growing up, Libby's. Oh, it is Libby, Libby, Libby on the label. If you like it on the table.
come on, my generation. Don't you leave me up here by myself. Any people from my generation? All right, let's sing it together as a congregation. Oh, it is sleepy, sleepy, sleepy. If you like it, like it, like it. Amen. They used to talk about the taste of Libby. Libby's corn, Libby green bean, Libby vegetables. Taste. David is talking about the presence of God. That no matter what, no matter how bad, you are blind. If you can find a way in your dark season, Lord Jesus, I don't know how, I don't know when, I don't know where, I don't know who, I just know in my darkest hour, if I will exalt the name of Jesus, which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess that you are the Lord of glory. In my darkest hour and in my moment of blindness when I don't know what to do, I don't know what to say but this. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be today? And you know what? In a moment of magnifying the Lord. 1, 2, 3. In just a moment of magnifying the Lord, it starts to get better. It just starts to get better. It doesn't mean that everything is fixed. It doesn't mean that everything is a bed of roses right now. God never promised us a rose garden. But in the moment where you just seem like you just can't, but you choose to, I can't lift my hand. And all of a sudden your brain will tell your arm, you better praise the Lord. And all of a sudden you'll feel glory. You'll feel an unction come up and you'll feel strength come to that arm. And you know, if you can just get one up, you can get two up. You're still in darkness. You're still at a place where I don't know how the bills are going to be paid. I can't keep gas in the car or food on the table. I don't know how my babies are going to get shoes, and I certainly can't afford diapers. I just know this, if I could just get my hands in the air. In the middle of doubt. Lord, I don't know even how to say praise. I just do what you tell me. And you begin to taste his presence. And you begin to taste his glory. Where all of a sudden you find yourself where those things just don't matter anymore. A few years ago, Judy and I were in a maximum security prison in Texas. It was women. There's probably 500 women in that prison. They were going to come to the service there. We were there and we were ministering. And they had the death row women. On death row, they were behind a glass. And they couldn't come out, but they could at least hear through a little speaker that was in. I'm going to need a chair up here if I could get a chair. Just somebody put me a chair right there. Just right over there, brother. Actually, it's just right there above. That's perfect. Thank you so much. And the Lord's working things out in your life. God is working things out. There's some things that are coming into alignment for you right now. I thank you, Lord, that what the enemy has meant for bad, the Lord wants you to know that you are his son and he is pleased with you. They've called you different and indifferent, but I, the Lord God, have called you my son, and I have called you that one that shall do the great and the mighty
in this season. I am lining things up. The tornado is cleaning up and the fire is burning. I see you're connected to many souls. Many men and women will come to the knowledge of Jesus Christ because of your story, because of your testimony, and because of your stand for the kingdom of God. I say it in Jesus' name. Now, I promote and I say and pronounce increase on your life like you've never seen it in Jesus' name. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise for that. We're in ministry and preaching and Judy singing and the women are on fire. You know, I mean, I preached in a men's prison just about a month ago, and they're more free in the prison than we are out here in the church. I'm telling you, I prayed for people. Pastor Rick, there were inmates and sergeants laid out on the floor on top of each other. You understand that? Guys in orange and guys in blue laid on top of each other under the power of the Holy Ghost. So we're in this ladies' prison. Maximum security women are back there, and Judy and I walk by the window, and they just put their hand up on the window just for a point of contact. They couldn't talk to you. They couldn't say anything, but if you just kind of touch the window, I can receive a blessing. And then we go, and there's 1,000 women. It's probably more like 1,000 women sitting in the audience, and Judy's doing Days of Elijah. She's doing all kinds of music, and they come in. When they bring them down the aisle, when they bring them in, it's in a tent. When they bring them in, I mean, Kirk Franklin music is jamming, and there's all kinds of music, Lecrae going, and all kind of stuff. Not a whole lot of Southern gospel music going on in the prison, I will say that, you know, but nothing wrong with Southern gospel music, but you're talking about people who come off the streets, you know, and you just try to connect with them. So all of this is the vibe under the tent. Judy's preaching and preaching and preaching, and these women they can't get up, they can't stand up, they can't do anything. All they can do is observe, and they can clap. But if you get up, you're escorted out from under the tent, and then you're disciplined for your actions in the moment. Well, there was this one lady who was sitting right on the front row. I never will forget this. And she's sitting on the front row, and man, she's having church. She's doing all she can possibly do without getting in trouble. Judy do a 2-beat song, and she's all over. She's doing everything she can possibly do to magnify the Lord in prison. And it's at one point she's sitting on her hands. You know, she's trying to do everything to contain the anointing on her life. And finally she had to make a decision. Do I continue to be miserable in my praise? Or do I make the decision to magnify the Lord in front of everybody, where it don't matter what happens, it don't matter what I go through, it don't matter what the result is? And at one point she finally just said, "Hallelujah! Glory to God! Glory to God!" I'm watching this, and here's all these women beside her and behind her, all, and she just, woo! 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 She made a conscious decision to say, it don't matter if they lock me up for the rest of the year. This situation is not going to steal my praise. This moment is not going to cancel my magnification of my Lord. I'm going for it, and I'm going all out. She's doing that. Everybody else is trying to be like they should be. And, you know, it was about 30 or 45 seconds. Here come the guards. And let me show you this picture. Come here, Erica. You'll help me out. Erica was the praiser. She was praising, and here come the guards, and you get one side on her elbow right there. And man, them guards got a hold of that woman and started dragging her out. Her feet never quit kicking. Her screaming never stopped. Hallelujah, glory, praise the Lord. And those guards are trying to contain the anointing. Those guards are trying to keep from being embarrassed. But the praise of that prisoner was so powerful. Oh, good glory to God. They took her out. They gave her 7 days of solitary because of her praise. How? They gave her, they said, this is what you're going to have to do. We're going to lock you up into solitary for 7 days for acting like that. Let me tell you something. From the supernatural, it was no act at all. When God the Father looked down at her, he said, that's my baby praising me in the middle of her pain, in the middle of her prison, in the middle of her problem. Oh, clap your hands in this church. One, two, three. Something about you. Something about me. There's something about every human being created in the image of God, which is, by the way, everybody. There was no cross at the time of creation. Everybody created is created in the image of God. Look at your neighbor and say, I look just like my daddy. We have the we're the only ones who have the privilege to magnify him. We were created to worship. We were created to praise. We were created to magnify. And what we do in public is as a result of what we've done in private. When you learn to magnify the Lord in a dark corner where nobody's there, there ain't no organ, ain't no guitar, no cello, no B3, no band, no anything. Whenever we can find it within ourselves to go, God, my praise is going to cost me something. But I'm going to take a risk. I'm jumping in. That prisoner said that day, I'm jumping in. This season that we're in, it is vital it is absolutely crucial, and it is vital to understand the value of your praise and your ability to magnify the Lord. As I said last night, you cannot operate in demonstration until you have accomplished distress. People are distressed. Life is distressed. Jesus went through stress. Jesus faced the obstacles and he overcame. We're at a place right now, and I'll just tell you this. There's situations, and I'm going to be the one to say it, in this house, and I may never get to come back, and that's fine with me. And I'm lying. I may never get to come back after I say what I'm about to say. But I'm going to say it. If you continue to waste time on the Lord and your relationship with the Lord, getting it right, serving him, and I'm not talking about being some religious person, something or another that's got to have a suit and tie on. I didn't want to put this thing on. I just wanted to be respectful. I'm not talking about religion. I'm talking about a relationship with Jesus Christ, who is the only way. He's the truth and the life. There is no other way to eternal life in heaven except through Jesus Christ. There is no drug, there's no alcohol, there's no marriage, there's not another marriage, there's not one relationship, another relationship. There is nothing that can compare to the love of Jesus. You say, well, how much did Jesus love me? I'm a waste of time. Well, Mr. and Mrs. Waste of Time, let me tell you. He loves you so much that he went to the cross. He shed every drop of blood that if you would have been the only person on the planet, he still would have fulfilled God's plan. He didn't have to have a big congregation to determine whether or not he was going to die on the cross. He died on the cross for one. And you can run as far as you want to run. You can be silent as long as you want to be silent. But I'm telling you, the hand of God will chase you down and change you forever. This church is entering a new season of praise. It's an attitude adjustment. There's an attitude adjustment. It ain't going to be the same anymore. He hadn't told me to come up here and say anything. Give my dear friends their magnifying glasses back. There is a move of God coming. And it's going to be so rampant. I told my people at Dwelling Place, get on or get out of the way. And I don't mean that in a mean way, but I have hungered for a lot of things in my life. I've hungered for a lot of things. I've desired a lot of things in my life. I've had some money in my life. I've had some great things in my life. I've gone after things in my life. Before I was married, I was in pursuit of being a musician and working in Nashville and making music and being a commercial drummer and all that. And God shut all of that down. And he said, you're not pursuing me. You're pursuing something that I haven't called you to be. And he used a man to tell me I wasn't good enough to do it commercially, to lead me to a small town called Cleveland, Tennessee, to meet my wife, ultimately to go to the nations of the earth. We've been to 65 different countries. We've seen hundreds of thousands of people saved. I've seen 750,000 people in one gathering dance to the beat of Days of Elijah, shouting and magnifying God in the heart of Nigeria. There's nothing like the presence of God. There's nothing like the ability to magnify him. You're worth something or he'd have never died. Can I get an amen? Amen. And where we are right now, thank you so much. Where we are right now, not just in Michigan and not just in Tennessee, not just in California, not just in New York, but in the world. Not just in the United States, but in the world. God is looking for a people that will make him bigger than the problem. Think about this. You think God's worried about the election? Are you kidding me? You think he's worried at all about your situation? God don't have the ability to worry. Because the Bible calls worry a sin. You don't have to worry. Listen, friend, you don't have to doubt. You don't have to give in to the situation. If you will just put your spiritual glasses on and begin to get your hands up in the air. And you know what? I would never be the person. I'm a pastor, so I would never be the person to say it don't hurt. I would never be the person to deny your situation. I would never be the person to say get over it. Not unless it was a silly situation and I had to get say, hey, you know what? You need to get over it. But pain is real. Problems are a reality. But it's what you do between point A and point B. Will you magnify the Lord or will you magnify the problem? And God is moving in this house right now. There's some people in the room, you've been magnifying the situation. You have made life bigger or life's problems bigger. And you've actually made God small in the situation. One of the most powerful words God ever spoke to me and my wife. We were going through some stuff. If I could have just a little less on the stage here. We were going through some stuff and she and I were on the floor, nose in carpet. As Rick said yesterday, Pastor Rick made a reference yesterday about eating carpet. Me and my wife, we were eating some carpet one day. We were nose in carpet and there was snot everywhere. That's a laugh moment, by the way, not to gross you out. And she and I are there and we're praying. This is before we had children. We were praying. It's about the second year of our marriage. We're seeking the Lord and I'm crying out. My wife's crying out, God, we need a word. We had reached a place in ministry where nothing was happening. No phone calls. There was no such thing as an email at the time. We weren't getting any phone calls. We weren't getting any invitations in the mail. And we were facing something. We didn't know what to do. And we were seeking the Lord. And all of a sudden, my wife raises up and she says, I've heard from the Lord. And I wanted to be the man of God to hear first. You know, I kind of wanted to go, no, it was me that heard him. She says, no, I've heard from the Lord. And this is what he has said to us. Everybody stand to your feet, by the way. Just stand to your feet. I'm going to ask for nobody else to leave. If you can help it, please don't leave. She sits up. And she says, this is what the Lord has said. She said, God says you have overestimated the power and the trickery of the devil in your life. And you have underestimated who I am and my power. And my ability and my anointing in your life. And she went on to say, and the Lord would say, you can't have me and him. You can't serve me and the devil. You have to pick one or the other. But to pick the other means that I have to bail out. If you're going to magnify your enemy, which is God's enemy, then I become a dim spectacle in your life. And I said, oh my goodness, we can't do that. We're called to be different. So we put some music on. We put the CD on, which birthed all night prayer. It birthed all night prayer. My wife and I used to pray all night, just the husband and wife, all night, one time a month on Friday night. We'd start at 10 and go to 6 o'clock in the morning. But that moment, that word from the Lord, where you've overestimated the enemy of your life and you've underestimated who I am, it birthed something in us to understand the power of magnifying the Lord bigger than my mess. If you're here this morning, you say, Pastor Jaime, I've made some things way too big in my life. I've allowed the economy situation to overwhelm me. That's not to say it didn't exist. Please don't misunderstand me. But we've got to recognize this, that when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Lord raises up a standard against him. And if you look at that in an original language, it reads like this. When the enemy comes in, comma, like a flood, the Lord raises up a banner and a standard against him. Everybody lift your hands in the room. If you're in this house today, you say, Pastor Jaime, this word and this message has spoken to me today. I'm going to pray for you. I want you to just start moving. There's some people here today. God is about to immediately make a change in your life. I speak that prophetically. I want you to come and stand right here in front of me. You've just made things way too big, way too big. God wants to be bigger. Come and stand side by side, side by side. Just line up right here in front of me, just across this room. That's right. Come on, come on, come on, come on. We're going to make him bigger today. We're going to make him bigger today. We're about to make God bigger today. We're pulling out our supernatural magnifying glasses. Some of you come just right over this way, right over this way. That's right, that's right. That's right. Praise God for this. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise for this. Come and get your guitar. Now here's what I want to tell you. The first thing I'm going to tell you and how you've got to pray is this. You have to ask the Lord to forgive you for making things bigger than him. And in reality, God is bigger than everything. Amen? Now, there's somebody here today. You've been dealing with an ear. I want to say, like, I'm going to say it's the left ear, but it may not be just the left ear. Somebody's dealing with some infection. It's almost real painful. It's been hard for you to even listen to me. Is that somebody in the room? Somebody in the room? Who is that dealing with the ear? You? If you'll come, stand right here in front of this line. Come right here. Is that you guys too? Okay, come stand right here. God's about to heal that. Right here. Yes, ma'am. Okay, right here. Somebody else? Who else is that? Is there somebody else? God's going to do this miracle right now. God's going to do this miracle right now. Is it the right ear for you? Okay. What about for you? Both ears? Okay. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Father, we just thank you. We make you bigger than this situation. We make you bigger than this infection. You are bigger than anything. You're bigger than all our problems today, Lord. And when I lay my hands on these ears, they're going to pop open. And the tension is going to release. The pain is going to go away. And the glory of God is going to rest right there in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit. That's it right there in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, just receive that. We got you. Don't you worry. That's glory. That's glory right there. Amen. Thank you. Be healed. I say in Jesus' name. I say in Jesus' name, that ear opens up. That pain goes. That pain goes. That infection goes. That blockage goes. And the devil is a liar in Jesus' name. The blood of Jesus. Amen. Now praise him for it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, right here. Thank you, Lord. Go ahead, KK. Thank you, Lord. I release the glory of God. God's going to heal this, but I see something greater on your life. Is this your husband over here? Yeah, come here. Come here, both of them. Hey, my man, you helped me preach today. High five. High five. Thank you. Awesome. I just see an open door happening. Thank you, Lord. Been struggling, fighting, toiling over situations. So many are. God says that the tornado is cleaning. It's almost like I see like a utility broom in your garage and you're just pushing junk out. God says, I'm about to clean out some stuff and replace it. I'm about to pour out blessings that you didn't know you were able or positioned to contain. And God says, I'm doing it. October is going to be the month of harvest for you, literally. And I say this in Jesus' name. I say over my man right here, my little guy. What's your name? Micah. Oh, my goodness, Micah. Micah, the man of God. I thank you, Lord, for your hand on them, God. Thank you for healing those ears. Thank you, Lord. I hear the Lord saying, it's joy unspeakable and full of glory. Full of glory, full of glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for it, Lord, over this house. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Amen. 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 Oh, Jesus. Sing that, baby. Everybody right here, just open your hands up as if you're going to receive a gift. Just want to receive something from the Lord. He's going to do something today. We're going
going to make God bigger. We're going to make God bigger.
Your presence.
We're pulling out the magnifying glasses and making God so much bigger. Come on, everybody in the house, sing this song. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hey, buddy, how you doing, man? High five.
Your presence is heaven to me.
Praise God. Praise God. Look at these beautiful babies. That's right, Lord. We make you bigger. We make you bigger. We make you bigger. We make you bigger. Your presence is heaven to me.
Oh,
Jesus. We're making you bigger, Lord. Your presence is
your presence is heaven.
Sing, sing.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh,
Jesus. Your presence is heaven.
Ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-la-na-na-na-ma-sa-ta. Those of you who have a prayer language, just begin to pray in that language. If you don't, that's no problem. Just, who is like the Lord in all the earth? Sing it, KK.
Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth?
That's right, that's right. Just worship, ladies. Come on. Gentlemen, just worship. You feel His glory. You feel in His presence right now. We're making the Lord bigger.
No, nothing in this world can satisfy. No, Jesus, You're the cup that won't run dry. Your presence is heaven to me. Yeah. Oh, Your presence.
That's right. Come on, let's worship.
Is heaven.
We're waiting on the Lord. We're waiting on the Lord. We're gonna worship Him first.
So we're singing.
Thank you. We release our praise to you, God. You're bigger than our problems. You're bigger than our pain. And Lord, as I pray for my brothers and my sisters right now, everything changes. I declare and decree that in this moment and in this day, it'll never be the same again. Right there in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Right there in Jesus' name for my sister. Right there in Jesus. I release the glory of God into your life, into your world, into your life, into your domain. I say in the name of Jesus that this season you have faced, God says, I am coming forward to bring you out and your family. There's a situation right now. I see it. I see it. Lord, I thank you, God, that you are bringing everything into order. In Jesus' name. I thank you for it, Lord. I thank you for it. I thank you for the power of God. We make you bigger, Lord. We make you bigger. Come on, church, pray. We make you bigger. We make you bigger. We magnify you. Make you bigger, Lord. You are bigger than. You are bigger than. You are greater than. And we thank you, Lord. You are greater than that. You are greater than that, Lord. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord. You are greater than.
You are better. There is none like
you. There's the glory of God.
You are better.
There's the glory of God. There's the anointing of God. There's the favor and the glory of God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
You are better.
I thank you, Lord, for this.
this house right here. I just standing here, I just read your shirt, and the Lord just told me you're about to live your shirt. You're about to live your shirt. You're actually wearing your prophetic word. God's going to live the life through you. I thank you that you are not just living the life, you are living the great life, says the Lord. You're about to experience the glory and the favor on your house, on your home, everything that concerns you, says the Lord. I am the Lord. Is there anything too hard for me, says the Lord? No, there's nothing hard for me. And I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I thank you, God, for restoration. All shall be well, says the Lord. From your head, down your spine, into your hips, into your legs, your knees, your ankles, your stomach. In Jesus' name, all shall be well. And God just busted out laughing. Come on, sit. Oh, Jesus, singing. Hey, babe. How are you doing? Thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit. Lord, I thank you, God, that things don't matter anymore. And you are magnified in this young lady's life. I thank you, Lord. She's a mover and a shaker. I thank you, Lord, that she is a woman of influence and impact in this city and in this culture, Lord. I thank you, God, that you're going to raise her up to be a mighty, mighty, mighty. I see an entrepreneurial anointing on your life. I see you raising up to do great things in the corporate world. And I release the glory of God on your life in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you for this man's faith, Lord. I thank you, God, and I release the glory of God that all shall be fine. Everything is going to be okay. Everything's going to be okay. God has got you in the palm of his hand and your family in Jesus' name. And I just release the peace and the glory of God on your life. You're a happy guy. You are a happy guy. I see the joy of the Lord in your life. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Who is like the Lord in all the earth? Sing that.
Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth?
Pastor Rick, there's a glory of God in this house. He's made this place his dwelling place. Thank you, Lord, that all is coming into order.
Nothing in this world satisfies.
Everything's coming into order right now. In Jesus' name.
Jesus,
in Jesus. We magnify the Lord. Oh, oh, magnify the Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord. There's the anointing. Oh, magnify the Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord. Make him bigger. Oh, magnify the Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord. Here he comes. Your presence. I release the glory of God.
Jesus, you're the
There he is. There's his presence. There's his glory. There's his favor. Thank you, Lord. Right there, prophetic release, prophetic release, prophetic release on your life. In Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. That's right. Worship in this house.
Your presence is heaven to me.
Thank you, Lord. Peace and calm assurance. And Lord, the pain has been tough. But the promise still exists. I see a dream in your life that you actually have given up on because of the toil. And the Lord says the dream is not dead. I haven't walked away from the dream because I'm the one who dreamt it first in you. And God, I just call right now
that your angel and angels would encamp round about her, and I release the healing waters flow. Here he comes. Come on, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Nothing like your presence. Nothing like your presence, Lord. All shall be well. God never said he didn't understand the pain. We magnify him. We magnify. We make you bigger than the situation. Our enemy will not get the glory. Our Lord gets the glory. I thank you, God, that it goes right through my sister today. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I see the Lord sending peace angels to your house. You have four bedrooms? Three? You have three bedrooms. I see like you got kids? They're teenagers. Are they at home? Are they living at home, like in the three bedroom with you? There's angels in your home intercepting the toil. The tornado. Whenever I said something about a tornado this morning, you thought, God, I feel like I'm in a tornado. And the tornado symbolizes the cleaning, okay? I mean, it stirs up a lot of things. There's a mess. There's all kinds of things going on. And God would say this, I am going to heal her heart. I am going to heal her heart in the next 60 days. In the next 60 days. Everybody hear what I'm saying. In the next 60 days. By Thanksgiving, at least. That's a little longer than 60 days. But in the next 60 days, you're going to see a major turnaround in your life and in your home. And things that you have been in the midnight hour dealing with. I see like dark times where you are, you're a praying woman. You seek the Lord. Somebody taught you how to pray. Somebody really, really instructed you. Who is this? Okay, somebody, she instructed you to pray. I see this current right here. And God says, I have not lost this battle. As a matter of fact, I heard you the first day you prayed. And like the UPS warehouse, I have sent packages and packages and packages and packages to you. But they've been held up by your enemy and my enemy. But the angel has won the battle. And now you're about to see the influx of the promises of God. And I say in Jesus' name, this is going to be the greatest holiday season you've ever experienced. Not because of just a bunch of presents under the tree, but because of the presence of God returning to your home. You receive this? In Jesus' name. Say, God, give me all you got. Give me all you got. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Whew. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Ah, na na ma so, da na na ma ye, da na na. Pure cleansing. This is your intercessor, Lord. She has changed the minds and the hearts of kings. Jesus' name, right there, it goes right through you. Thank you, Lord. Now, Father, I just say right there over that mother and that grandmother, the enemy of her soul and of her life is so afraid of her because she has shaken and quakened the foundations of hell. Give her the blessing she deserves. Give her that. Give her that, Lord. In Jesus' name. Go ahead, girls. Keep singing. That's just awesome stuff what you're doing there. Whoo. Thank you for that miracle. Thank you for that miracle. Thank you for that miracle, Lord. I just release healing. I just release. Oh, da na na ma she hekata. Oh, that's like fresh water. Fresh water. Thank you, Lord. Peace. Peace of mind. Peace of mind. Peace be still. Knowing that I, the Lord God, keep. I keep and I protect. In Jesus' name. Thank you.
you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. More, God. There it is. More. You've been asking for more of the Lord. God says, I'm going to overflow you now. I see lost loved ones coming to Christ. Those you've been praying for, those you've been seeking God after. Five people are going to get raises in the next 30 days. There's somebody about to get major, like a 10, 20, and actually even a 50% increase. Who's that for? That's for somebody, because God just interrupted me and said, major raises and bonuses. Major raises and bonuses. Somebody's been praying for it. Who's been praying for that specifically? In the next 30 days. Do you work a job? Are you a supervisor of some kind? No. Pediatric nurse. Thank you, Lord. Oh, my goodness. There's an anointing on your life, actually, for healing. There's healing in your hands. There's a child about to come that you're going to see a miracle happen. It's going to be in that office. You're going to see. Are you in the hospital? You're in the hospital, right? You work in the hospital, emergency room? Okay. There's a major miracle that's about to happen when you lay hands on this child. And I'm not putting a burden on you. I'm putting a calling on you that says there's healing in your hands. Now, you have to do your job, and I respect that. But there's a power to pray that culture in the world can't do anything about. And you've been seeking the Lord. God, use me greater than my abilities. So I just hold your hands out. Here comes glory. And I see something kind of over in the corner of your bedroom, like a some type of a nightstand or a something that's got a lamp on it. And there's some notes there. That's your personal, just personal items, little things that you and only you and the Lord. God says, I know the thoughts that I have towards you, says the Lord. Not to harm, not to hurt, not to destroy, but to give you a hope and a future. You've been very faithful when it wasn't popular. And God says, I am about to promote my daughter on a level that she's never even imagined. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Write the vision down and make it plain. Right? You have written down some stuff. You've written down some vision and some desires and dreams. And I thank you for it. Thank you for it. Thank you for it. Oh, my goodness. In a year from now, you'll be prancing around like something and somebody. Your personality won't even be recognized. It's almost like you're going through metamorphosis. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord. You love Jesus? Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Is that Anna? Annie? Is that the middle name, Annie? Lord, I just thank you for what you're doing in her life right now. What is your name? Wendy? Lord, I thank you for Wendy. I thank you, Lord, that you are doing something fresh. I just see God doing this right here over you. Expansion. You do hair or something? What do you do? What do you do? You're in a hospital. Are y'all at the same hospital? No? I see just expansion over your life. You got family? Are you married? No? Children? Okay. Are they young children? Okay. I see expansion. I just see like just God doing that right there over your life. And I don't know what you've been seeking the Lord for, or even if you're seeking the Lord for something, but you've actually allowed what everybody else thought to discourage you from what you've asked God for. Do not listen to the voices. Get away from the noise. I've got this application on my phone. It's white noise. All the babies have a white noise machine. Keeps them to sleep. I still use one. I'm 52 years old. Why do I use that? It blocks out all the noise, supernatural white noise in your life. Because God says, I've already given you promises, and my promises are yes and amen. They will and they shall happen. But you've allowed the noise to distract you from what God told you you could do and what you could have. Does your spirit bear witness with this? Father, in Jesus' name, supernatural increase over Wendy today, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Who's Joe? Who is Joe? Is there a Joe in your life? Joseph? No Joseph? No doctor named Joseph? Anybody Joseph around you? Okay, that's fine. Somebody's got connected to a Joe right in here. I'm not sure who that is. Is that you? Okay, I'm coming. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord. And there's healing in the body. Thank you, Lord. Like a blood condition. Okay, thank you, Lord. Total restoration. Total restoration. Total healing. Say, God, I receive it. I receive it in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Hey, darling, can I pray for you? Yeah, what's your name? Elizabeth, there's something inside of you that's mighty. You believe that? Do you like to color? Yeah. You like to draw pictures? Yeah, I see that as well. I'm going to give you a present. Lord, I just pray for my little friend Elizabeth today, God. Witty inventions, creative ideas, God. I thank you, Lord, that she's the life of the party. She's going to tell people about Jesus. Amen. 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 Lord, I just release over this house, over this baby, Lord. I thank you for your word early today, God. I release the glory of God, the presence and the spirit of God over this family, over this house. In Jesus' name. You know what that means, right? Explosion. Father, in Jesus' name, who's Joe? Okay? The whole family is Joe. Okay, that's why I said, heard the Lord say, hey, Joe. Sweet, calm assurance. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Tough nights. You've had some tough nights. Tough nights, long nights, sleepless nights, looking up at the ceiling fan nights. I thank you, Lord. Right here, come on. Like lava, the peace of God just slowly overwhelms you right now. There it comes. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You're bearing a burden for a child or something. You're bearing a heaviness for a child. I say and I release that in Jesus' name. It's okay. God doesn't embarrass his children. And Lord, I thank you today, on this day, September the 18th, that things are coming into alignment right now. And I say the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar and the devil is destroyed. We're making God bigger than this situation. I hear these words, and I don't say this to appease you, but I do hear these words. Mom, I'm home. Mom, I'm home. Mom, I'm home. Mom, I'm home. Peace that goes beyond your ability to comprehend and understand. Lord, this lady has suffered. I'm asking, Lord, for a total overhaul. In Jesus' name. Is it a white house? You have a white house? Something light brick? Okay. So I just see the Lord's angels just kind of moving in right now to your. I just see a white house, but you're saying it's light colored brick. Maybe that's angels moving into the white house. Maybe that's what's happening. So we just say in Jesus' name, you're about to experience a season of glory. Look at me, okay? You don't have to be shamed in any way. There's a season of glory coming on your life. You're going to start seeing some things come back together.
and the what I see almost like a group of Joes. I'm not sure what's going on with the group of Joes, but there's some experiences spiritually with each one of them. Okay, so it's your last brother to be saved. And how old is he, may I ask? 57. Lord, come on home, Joe. Come on home. Come to church. In Jesus' name, Joe. Well, the Lord just said that to me, Joe, because God's going to save him. God's going to save him. He's going to be a mighty man of God. He's going to finish his life strong. He's going to finish his life healed and restored. But it's going to be because of Jesus in his life. Amen. Amen. This is about to be a great year for you. Amen. 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 Are you with my buddy over here? Okay. Can I have the whole family? Can I have the whole family? I've been watching y'all all morning. All morning long, the Lord pointed you out to me. And it wasn't because of the bandana. I'm all about that too. Well, see, I don't need a bandana to cover my hair. So, but I see, man, you are gorgeous. Look at these pretty ladies. My God, this church is full of pretty young ladies. My goodness. Is that what it is? Do you play something? You play an instrument? No? What do you do? Over road or local? Okay. I see somebody sings. Who sings? Is it you? Okay. Do you write music? Okay. All right. Have you written some country music? Okay. Recorded anything? Okay. There's somebody right here just within this group, and it's because of this gift on you, and it's going to come down through here. There's some music that's going to happen. It's going to happen quickly. It's going to happen early. And I'm not sure which one that is, but there's one of them here that's very gifted to be a singer. And so I hear that. But I also see the spirit and the strength of restoration of all things on your life. You're going through some stuff. You're fighting some things. And God is lining it up. You thought it was over, as a matter of fact. You've actually given up in some areas of your life. But God says, no, I'm not going to let you do that. I'm not going to let you do that. I see supernatural strength come into your life, your emotions, your body, your mind. Okay? The devil is a liar. I curse the spirit of destruction. I curse the lie of the enemy that fights against you. Okay? I curse the nightmares. I break that over your life right now. No more. I say in Jesus' name, peace comes. Peace comes.
That a rest is coming over her right now in the name of Jesus. That every single lie, every single tormenting thought has to leave right now in the name of Jesus. I say, God, you are higher, you are greater than every single other lie in her life and in this family's life in the name of Jesus. I say that God has not given you a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and a sound mind. Of power, of love, and a sound mind. Of power, of love, and I want you to say that. Of power, of love, and a sound mind. Of power, of love, and a sound mind. Say it till you believe it. A power of love and a sound mind. God has not given you a spirit of fear. You can walk out this life with freedom from fear. You can live fearless. fearless. I don't care what people have said over you. I don't care that people have said, I fear this, and you have to fear it too. I break that off of you in the name of Jesus. You can live a fearless life, and the life that you used to live is broken in the name of Jesus. And fear of doors ever from your past life ever opening up again, I rebuke that lie in the name of Jesus. I call you a fearless daughter of God today in the name of Jesus. Devil, get your hands off of this family.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. I curse fear over this entire family in the name of Jesus. It stops today in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that each one of them are children of God, that you've called them with purpose and of goodness and of faithfulness.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, a peace that passes all understanding.
That's right.
You're going to wake up, and you're not even going to understand why you have so much peace.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Come on, church. Come on, church. Amen. Amen. All shall be well. All shall be well. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Anybody in here like to receive Jesus as your Savior? Is anybody in here? You're not saved. You'd say, I want Jesus in my life. I'd like to receive Christ. Anybody in here, you felt something, heard something? You just tired of serving the devil and you want to serve the Lord now? Anybody? Come on, we're all sinners saved by grace. We're all. Amen. What a house of champions. Thank you so much for having us. Pastor Rick, Pastor Renee, thank you so much for having us. Isn't God good? Isn't God amazing? Come on, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. One in the spirit. One in the spirit. Ma'am, right there in the straight. Can you stand up? Can you? Yes, ma'am. Oh, I just feel the Lord moving right now on your behalf. Just lift your hands if you would. A situation you're fighting. God says, I have favored you. Forget what everybody else is saying. As a matter of fact, is it a court case or something you're dealing with? Anything in your life like that? Yes? Is it a court case specifically? Okay. Two. Okay. God says, I have placed my favor on you. I'm sorry. Excuse me. You didn't think the Lord knew you that well. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Your story is strong, says the Lord. Your story is strong. You've been through some tough times, some tough days, and I have preserved you, and I've raised you up for such a time as this, would say the Lord. Forsake not what I have for you. You are the favored. I see a season of favor, like just favor, and you're going to walk through this battle. You're going to come out as pure gold, says the Lord. Do not fear. I curse fear, doubt, and unbelief. And I say the joy of the Lord is your strength. And you're going to walk out of this situation shining. I release that in Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Jesus loves you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Woo. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank God. Thank you, Lord, for just your overwhelming presence that's been in this building today and this weekend. Can I get an amen, right? How many of you have enjoyed this weekend? How many of you felt the presence of the Lord, not just enjoyed the weekend, right? We didn't come here for a concert, right? We came here to experience God and to feel his presence. And I know that personally, I have felt his presence in so many ways this weekend. So, I'm just going to go ahead and dismiss the service, and then we can go about with our day. So thank you, Lord God, for the ability to come together and to worship you, Lord God. Lord. I thank you for the presence that's in this building, Lord God. I thank you for the anointing that's on each person, Father God. Father God, I pray that the words that were spoken over the people today, Lord God, that they would not stay dormant, Lord God, but that they would be stirred up inside of each and every person. Father God, I come against the enemy that would come to steal, kill, and destroy from each person in this building, Lord God, to try and keep them from their God-given destiny, Lord God. But I say that you are greater, that you are bigger, Lord God, and that your presence in their life and in our church is bigger, Father God. I pray that we would not magnify the problem, Lord God, but that we would magnify you throughout this whole week, Lord God. Father God, give us a new perspective, Father God, and a new vision, Father God. And I just thank you for the stirring up that you have caused this weekend, Lord God. I pray that you would be with our guests, Lord Father God, as they go about, Father, and as they go to speak to the nations, Lord God. I just say that you are with them, Lord God, that you would pave the way before they even get there, Father God. And I just thank you and praise you and give you honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen.